Valentine's Day. It's not always hearts and love. Sometimes February 14th can be tragic. Take Jessi Klein, for example. Miss Klein began her Valentine's as she does every year, alone in the parking lot of a urine-soaked motel off an anonymous highway. And, just like every year, when a car pulled up, she backed cat-like into the shadows.
Hey, it's so dark out here. I didn't see you. Why don't you step into the light? Oh my goodness. Are your legs tired? Because last night, you were running all around, all over the place.
Do you mean I was running through your dreams?
Oh yeah, more like bouncing though, baby. I'm one of those little trampolines. What's your name, precious little angel?
I'm Jessi. You must be Rod.
With a capital D. You know what I mean?
Yeah, you look like a rod.
It's probably true, but don't waste your voice on my name right now, because you'll be screaming it later.
Why am I going to scream your name?
I don't know.
Are you going to murder me?
Yeah, I am, in the bedroom.
Why are you going to murder me in the bedroom?
Look, you sure ask a lot of questions there, don't you, Jenny?
My name is Jessi.
Right. I should remember that because I'll be screaming it later.
When I murder you.
Yeah, in the bedroom.
Or anywhere. You know what? Why don't we go upstairs and meet the others?
All right.
And so it began. Jessi took Rod by the hand and led him into the motel. The night was about to turn bloody. Radio Happy Hour presents The Curse of the Balls of Cupid. Brought to you by Chocolate Men. Is it a heart-shaped box of delicious chocolates? Or is it a package of randomly selected powerful medications? It's both! Chocolate Meds. Excuse me, sir. Would you care for a chocolate?
Oh, I love chocolate. Mmm, this chocolate is delicious.
Noticing any side effects?
Well, my nose is bleeding and I seem to be growing boobs.
What about your eczema?
Holy cow, it's almost gone! Thank you, Chocolate Man.
I was suffering from an awful toothache, but then I ate one delicious chocolate, and now all I have is a yeast infection. Thank you, Chocolate Man.
We purchase leftover medications directly from the manufacturers, dissolve them into delicious milk chocolate, and bring them to you at a low cost. Say, sir, what do you think of those coconut sprinkles?
Well, I think those coconut sprinkles gave me a painful erection.
Oh, don't worry, Tiger. It'll go down in a few days. Chocolate Med. Powerful drugs, delicious chocolate. Proud sponsor of the Radio Happy Hour presents The Curse of the Balls of Cupid. Jessi led Rod into the motel, through the lobby and up to a private room. Jessi introduced Rod to the three other guests.
Rod, this is Jolie Holland.
Oh my god. I must have just spilled some Windex in my underpants because, ooh, I can see myself in them.
You can see yourself in your own underpants?
Yeah, I can. Maybe you want me to spill some Windex in your underpants too.
Maybe you wanted me to kick you in the nuts.
That the worst hiccup of this party, then this evening should be just fine.
Did somebody say underpants? Because I left mine in the parking lot.
Oh boy. Rod, meet Fernandez.
No. That is what Mother used to call me. Please to call me Stupid Fresh.
Stupid Fresh is Lithuanian, obviously.
I am Pimp. And magazine salesperson.
Well, it's good to meet you, Stupid Fresh.
You too.
Jessi, I've been to better singles mixers at a prison.
Why did you go to a singles mixer at a prison?
Why do you ask so many questions?
Just be patient, Jolie. These people might be a little rough around the edges, but they're single, and they're not so bad.
And Rob, I no wait for introduction. My name is Martini. It is the only name you need to remember. You and I will make a nasty business tonight. Of this I am certain.
You will?
All right, you mean like intercourse?
It will be bestial, degenerate lovemaking, reminiscent of a donkey eating a dolphin.
I haven't seen anything like that since I was in ag school back in Miami.
I am going to murder you with my vagina.
Hey, Rob, perhaps you buy a magazine subscription from me after she murdered you with a vagina?
Yeah, sure thing, stupid fresh.
Good.
Jessi, I'm gonna leave. If I hurry, I can still make visiting hours at the penitentiary. I mean, at the other party I was going to.
No, wait, you can't go. I'll be the only normal woman here.
Yes, Jessi and Martini, only normal women left to take on two boys at a Valentine's Day sex orgy.
Please stay. You don't know how much planning went into this stupid party.
Sorry, sucker. Jolie Holland out. Peace.
Don't worry, Jessi. Martini, go first.
Oh. Ah, I didn't see you there. Jessi, some weird guy's at the door.
Oh my god, he's got an arrow sticking out of him. Are you okay?
I've been shot with an archaic weapon by one of you.
Oh my god, I think that guy's dead.
Oh, blood is spurting all over stupid fresh, his tracksuit.
The bleeding man accused one of us of shooting him with a bow.
He was looking at Jolie.
Don't pin this on me, man. Any one of you could have done this.
Look! The dead man has something in his pocket. It looks like giant tennis balls.
Tennis balls? Oh, poor guy. I had a tennis elbow once. I thought that was bad.
Those are not tennis balls. Those are giant Italian pearls. Priceless. These only two in the whole world. I know them well. Some say they are accursed. These pearls, party people, are known as the balls of a cupid.
Radio Happy Hour presents The Curse of the Balls of Cupid. Brought to you by Chocolate Man. This Valentine's Day, give your sweetie the delicious chocolate with the powerful medication. Who knows? Maybe it'll clear up her acne. On sale now.